a beautiful morning and it's basically cold. I didn't expect that since I was in May. I was camping here and it was basically much more warmer than this in July now. Anyway, just keeping up my morning routines. Session and it was basically not so good in the start, and later I moved to the left side and it was amazing because where I had the first wave it was like catching the flow, you know, we were going up and down, and this was basically the first time. And now I'm just having a lunch and I just moved a little bit on my camp. I actually lost one of my FCS2 fins. I don't know how this could happen, because normally they are really strong and sitting in the fin box. Now finally the sound came out again. Okay guys, now after my surf session I just want to show you around at Unster, and you have so many tiny and small nice houses around this place, and of course you still got some farmers here still doing their field grass for animals in Norway, and yeah, just have a look on your own. There's the beach. Here you got some mountain tops where you can go hiking. And even here right in front of you, it's a really nice mountain top where you can go from right side up and going on the lower part up completely to the top. So you have a good point of view. right in front of you, you got the old road. It was used before they built the tunnel at Unstad. And it has had lots of difficulties because of snow avalanche, especially in the winter time, and it's really rough, could be on the winter time here, blowing a lot of storms and a lot of wind. Because you can get like fall winds from both sides of the mountains, actually three sides, and then you have the open sea on the other hand. But anyway, it's a really nice place and it's fantastic to be here. All the people are really nice and friendly, so it's worth a visit. So I can highly recommend it. Yeah, that's a lot of people today here. As you see, it's completely full, crowded, all the parking places are occupied. And remember, if you go to Unstad, respect the privacy of locals, because everything is private property, so you cannot just go somewhere and park and do whatever you want. The only place what you can use, it's basically the parking places and camping site on the beach. And here you got the account for pay for a parking place. It's just a small amount, and it's for the common good, because people want to have a toilet and fresh water. So it's important that people are going to pay as well, because everything costs money and it's really not mad a lot of money what they like to have. Welcome back everybody. It was an epic weekend basically. The waves were huge, and that for the summertime, and it was quite fun. Had some really good waves, and yeah, there were other disadvantages. I had two longboards, they were coming in my back and driving over me basically, and I just wanted to go out. So even if you want to go out on the water, you need to watch your six basically. Yeah, it was really exhausting weekend. Today it's now Monday, and I will leave one day earlier because the conditions are getting not so good any longer, and on Tuesday it's getting to rain a lot again, and anyway I'm so exhausted that I need rest. So yeah, but I will be back with surfing, and stay tuned. Hit the thumb up and leave a comment, of course. Thanks.